in my diamond yoga. I'm Tammy Moore. I'm so happy you're joining me today. We're going to be working with our root chakra today and finding some space, opening up in our hips. So this is a 30-minute flow focused on the hips. You can go ahead and grab a blanket or a bolster if you like. And we'll begin by coming into a comfortable seat. Feel the ground beneath you and begin to focus on your breath, breathing in and out through your nostrils. Filling up your belly as you inhale, and as you exhale, ground into your root chakra. Feel the mat supporting you. Relax your shoulders, relax your jaw, relax the top of your head and your neck. Relax your eyes, relax your ears. Take any adjustments you need, settle in. Take a couple more rounds of breath here. Happy Friday, everybody. You can go ahead and close your eyes if you'd like. I love to practice yoga with my eyes closed. It helps me to really connect. Maybe now is a good time to start to think of an intention. Sankalpa, a purpose. If none is coming to you, that's fine also. Listen to yourself as you breathe, without judgment, without expectation. Start to make your exhales a little bit longer than your inhales. Grounding down, feeling those hips, noticing where you are. And lengthen the spine, sitting up tall on your next inhale. Sigh it out, open mouth, lion's breath. Release into your mat, into the support below you. On an inhale, reach those arms up, flood your shoulders away from your ears. Beautiful. Reaching up, reaching through your fingers, reaching down through your sits bones, down through that tailbone. Relax those shoulders down the back. Exhale. On an inhale, find length in that spine before turning to the right, reaching behind you, taking that right hand and hooking it on the left leg. Your gaze will be behind you. On an inhale, straighten up, find a little bit of length. Knit up through your core, and on your exhale, bend maybe a little bit deeper into that stretch. You are beautiful just as you are. Gorgeous work. Inhale, come bring your arms up through the center. Exhale, twisting to the left. Knitting up as you inhale, bringing your gaze to that back wall, grabbing that left knee, pulling your sits bones onto the mat. Knit up and find length in that spine before exhaling and finding a deeper stretch. Beautiful. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, bring your arms down to the sides. Beautiful. On an inhale, bring your legs out in front of you. I'm going to put mine to the side here, that you're not just looking at the bottoms of my feet. And we're gonna inhale, reach your arms up, find length in that spine, beautiful. And fold forward, reaching your two peace fingers around the big toe. Trying to bring your torso to your thighs. On an inhale, find a flat back, lift up, exhale, bending at the hips. Let the head hang here. And breathe. Whatever chitta-vritti is coming up, you can tell it to come back later. You will pay attention, or you won't, to it later. Ask it politely to leave for the moment. You are breathing, you are in yoga. And then inhale, reaching back up, excellent. Baby back bend as we cactus our arms.
Gorgeous.
Inhale, bring those arms down and wrap the legs to one side or the other, coming into your tabletop. As you come into tabletop, make sure that you're stacking your shoulders over your wrists, that you're pressing into your first finger and your thumb, that you are stacking your hips over your knees. Knees can be about hip distance apart as well. You can kind of move your bum from side to side, check in, give yourself a little bit of movement, and make sure that your biceps are flooded away from your ears here. Your elbows are pointing to the east and west. Inhale and bring your core, bring your navel to your spine. Pressing into the tops of your feet, your first fingers and your thumb. Finding length in your spine, reaching in both directions. Pressing into this tabletop. And breathe. On an inhale, we'll come into our cat-cow, going first into our cow, shining our heart forward. Exhale, navel to spine. Pressing into our feet and curving that back spine, really finding expansion across the back. Inhale for cow, reaching in both directions and being led by the breath and spine. Exhale, navel to spine, expansive back. Inhale. On an inhale, start to bring this into dynamic circles toward the front first and going toward the right. Shining your heart forward. Exhale. First through your left hip, then your right. Inhale as you come toward the front. Reaching through the crown of your head. Exhale. Down through child's pose. And take it around back, starting with your exhale, going to the right first, and then the left. Inhale, shine your heart forward as you come around the front. Exhale, as you sink deep into those hips, deep into those hips. Remember, this is a hip opener class. You can even spend time going back and forth here between them. Before you inhale and come around again toward the front. Exhale. Letting go of any tension, making sure that you're keeping it equal, go in both directions. Take a couple more rounds. Beautiful, and I'll meet you into a neutral tabletop position, stacking our shoulders over our wrists, our hips over our knees. Beautiful job, excellent. We're gonna untuck our toes, push up and kind of rock forward, giving ourselves a flat back, bringing our pelvis into neutral, for a high plank. So in this position as well, bring that navel to spine, activate in your glutes, activate in your thighs, press into all four corners of your hand. Find length in that spine, reaching through the crown of the head all the way through the tailbone. Take one round of breath here. Exhale. On your next inhale, we're going to come down all the way to our belly, keeping our elbows tucked, coming down all the way to our belly, untuck our toes. On our next inhale, press up for baby cobra. Shine that heart forward, beautiful. You can bring it all the way up to up dog if you'd like. Keeping that activated through your legs, beautiful, breathe. On your next exhale, meet me in downward facing dog. Beautiful. So that was our vinyasa, or at least the mat portion of the vinyasa. We're going to go ahead and do a full vinyasa after we take a couple rounds of breath here. So go ahead and walk your dog. Beautiful. You can look forward, hop, skip, or jump to the top of the mat. And standing forward, fold. You can spread your feet about hip distance apart here, wider if you'd like. Take a big bend in those knees and sway back and forth. You can rest your thighs on your torso, maybe grab opposite elbows here and let your head hang. Very nice. And breathe. Notice where you are. Notice. Give yourself gratitude. Your mat. Inhale that which is serving you and giving you energy, and exhale whatever is no longer serving you. Nod your head yes, no, yes one more time. On an inhale, we'll come right on up, all the way reaching up into a good morning stretch. Reaching up, bring your hands together above your head, through your third eye, through heart center, and down at your sides, Tadasana, mountain pose, balancing your weight through both of your feet, pressing into all four corners of your feet. On an inhale, shine your heart forward, exhale, feel the connection to the ground beneath you. Begin to let go of tension in your legs, in your low back, in your hips. Take a couple rounds of breath here. From here, on an inhale, reach your hands one more time, all the way up to the ceiling. Dive all the way over. Careful not to hit your couch. Standing forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Find that flat back. Length through your spine. Flood those shoulders away from the ears. Beautiful. Exhale, forward fold. Plant those hands in front of you. Step your right foot and then your left foot back for high plank. Engage your core, your glutes, your thighs, finding that flat back, pushing into your hands. On your next inhale, come down, Chaturanga Dandasana, all the way down to your belly, pushing up through your hands for up dog or baby cobra. On your next exhale, downward facing dog. Pressing into your heels, flood those hips toward the ceilings, up and back. Gorgeous. Find expansion across the back,
of your body. Press into that first finger and your thumb. On an inhale, kick that right leg back up behind you. Exhale, knee to nose and hold. Inhale, kick it up, flex that foot. Exhale, plant the foot between the palms, coming up for warrior one. You're gonna plant your back foot, press into that left foot behind you as you bend your right knee, being careful not to bring it over the toes. Check your alignment so your heel is lining up with the arch of your foot behind you. Reach high to the sky and square your hips toward the front. Feeling that line of energy as you push into that back foot, push into your knee. Check your alignment, make sure you can turn it in or out, move it either direction. Breathe. Beautiful, that's gorgeous. Inhale, on your next exhale, open to the right for warrior two. Open all the way up to that back wall. Shine your heart completely open. Beautiful. Flip that palm on an inhale. Reverse your warrior. Reaching through that right side body. Exhale back to warrior two. Gorgeous. Breathe. And hold. That hand on an inhale, reverse your warrior. Reaching through the side body, exhale. Sinking deeper into your bended knee on the right. On an inhale, bring it back around to extended side angle, reaching all the way the opposite direction with your left hand. Breathing into that left side body, pushing into that back left foot. You can let that right arm hang down or to a block or bolster. Shine your heart forward. Don't allow yourself to collapse too much. Reach. Beautiful. Inhale, come back up, warrior two. Beautiful. Really feel those hips opening up here on the right. Gorgeous work. Inhale, warrior one. Reaching up through the front, squaring those hips, pressing in through that back leg, pulling back with your right hip, pressing forward with your left, letting those shoulders away from your ears. Inhale, reach up, swan dive those hands around that right foot. Turn your toes, bring your knee down to coming up. Or low lunge. Knitting up through your muscles all the way through the center. Engaging through the core. Reaching up. Gorgeous. Bring that right foot back to meet the left. Gently back bend as you cactus your arms on your next exhale. Inhale, come on up. Gently with control down into child's pose. If you keep your legs together here, you'll really give your low back a nice break. If you'd like to do extended child's pose and have your knees going east and west, that's fine as well, with the belly in the middle, whatever is feeling good for you. Bring your forehead to the mat. You can reach your arms up long in front of you. Breathe. Notice where your mind is. Notice where your thoughts are. Notice what goes on when things are difficult. Press into your fingers if they're joined in front of you. If they're flat, gripping the mat, press into them.
Fold those shoulders back. Breathe. Press into your hips, finding space. Release. On an inhale, come back into tabletop, neutral position. Check your alignment here. Check that your shoulders are over your wrists. Kind of move your hips from side to side. Woo, they've been doing good. You've been doing great. All right. Woo, okay, so on an inhale, we're gonna untuck those toes, pressing our hips up into high plank. Engaging our core, finding that flat back. Flood those shoulders away from the ears. Have the elbows go to east to west without hyperextending. Press into the first finger and the thumb. And hold, reaching in both directions, pressing into the heels of the foot. Beautiful. Feel that stretch. Beautiful. On your next inhale, bring that plank forward. Bend your elbows, keeping them at your ribs. Come all the way to your belly, forehead to the mat for Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, press up for baby cobra or up dog. On your next exhale, downward facing dog. Press into those back heels, feeling that energy. Walk your dog. Gorgeous. Breathe through the back. Relax that head. Release your neck. On your next inhale, look forward. Hop, skip, or jump. Bend your knees and hop, skip, or jump to the front of the mat. Beautiful. Standing forward fold. Bend your knees here, take opposite elbows. Whatever suits you, whatever is calling you, go for it. On an inhale, come right on up, reaching to the sky. Exhale, bring your hands to your third eye, down through heart center, and down at your sides. Inhale, come on up, reaching your hands all the way up. Exhale, coming through heart center, all the way down, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, stepping your right foot back, then your left high plank. Inhale, pressing into your hands as you bend your elbows all the way to your belly. Forehead makes contact with the mat, untuck your toes. On an inhale, press up for up dog or baby cobra. On your next exhale, swing those hips up into the sky, up and back. Press through your heels for downward facing dog. Beautiful vinyasa. Breathe. Press into those heels. Walk your dog if that feels good. On an inhale, kick that left leg back. Exhale, knee to nose and hold, flat back. Engage through your core. Inhale, kick that left leg up, pressing through both hands. Exhale, bring it in between your palms. Turn your back right foot onto the ground and come up. Warrior one, squaring those hips to the front of the room, pressing into that back foot. Your back foot's at a 45 degree angle with your toes facing the top right corner of the mat. Reach toward the ceiling. Check with your alignment. Make sure your knee is not protruding over your toe or in one direction or the other. Reaching forward, beautiful, and breathe. Inhale, find length before opening to the right. On your exhale, warrior two. Keep that gaze over your left hand. Breathe.
Flip that palm on an inhale, reverse your warrior. Reaching through that left side body. Beautiful. Exhale, warrior two. Shine that heart forward, find length in the spine. And check your alignment, settle deeper into that pose. Breathe. Opening through the chest. Inhale, flip your palm. Reverse your warrior. Reaching through that side body. This time we're going to reach forward as we come back with our right hand for extended side angle. Make sure you don't collapse here. Shine that heart forward. Yes. Put your hand on the floor, your left hand on a block. When you're ready with control, come on up. Back to warrior two. Opening up. Beautiful. On an inhale, square those hips forward. Reach forward for warrior one. Beautiful. Breathe. Pressing forward on your right hip, pulling back on your left. And a little bit more length here and breathe. As you exhale, cartwheel those hands around the left foot, turn the right toes, bring that right knee to the ground, coming up for low lunge. Feel the hips here. Exhale. Beautiful. Reach up through the spine. Bring that left leg to meet the right. Gorgeous. And baby back bend as you cactus your arms on your exhale. Inhale, reach those arms up, flood your shoulders away. Exhale with control into child's pose. Bring your forehead to the mat. Slowly rock it side to side. Press into your hands and release. Breathe, notice where your thoughts are. Come back to your intention. If you have them. If not, come back to the present moment. Feel the sights and sounds around you. And focus on your breath. Feel the energy. All fours coming into tabletop. Untuck your toes, press up through your palms and through your toes, coming into high plank. Exhale, activate your core. Inhale, bend your knees in, coming down before. Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, pressing up. Cobra up. On your next exhale, press up for downward facing dog. Pushing those hips up and back toward the ceiling, pressing through your heels, pushing them toward the mat. Pressing your first finger and your thumb into the mat, letting your head bend. Beautiful work. Gorgeous. Bend your knees and look forward. On an inhale, hop, skip, or jump, baby steps.
toward the front of the mat, standing forward. On an inhale, come right on up, chair pose. Sinking your hips way down low. Reaching toward the ceiling, hands are by your ears. Feeling that length in the spine, kind of doing a chin lock, tucking it just a little bit. Breathe. On an inhale, we're going to bring our hands to heart center before twisting to the right. Pressing into our palms. Gorgeous. Breathe, let that head hang. Inhale, back through center, chair pose. Inhale, chin lock before exhaling and twisting to the left. Hands at heart center, pressing the hands together. Finding that deep bend in those hips. Inhale, reaching up. Exhale, forward fold. You can heel toe your feet out here, taking a wider stance. Bend the knees as much as you need to. Rest your thighs. Rest your torso on your thighs. Excuse me. Grab opposite elbows, maybe. And let it hang. Beautiful. Inhale, find a flat back. Exhale, reach all the way up. Hands to your third eye, to your heart center. And down as we come into our comfortable seat. Begin to breathe. Coming into our comfortable seat. Notice where your hips are as you root down, filling up your belly and grounding down through your hips. Do a little bit of a chin lock, feeling releasing in your neck. On an inhale, sit up as tall as you can. Feel that connection to your sit bones. Feel it all the way down your back. On an inhale, bring your right ear to your right shoulder. Exhale. Inhale, drop your gaze 45 degrees. Exhale. Inhale, chin to chest. Exhale. Inhale, left ear to left shoulder. Release that shoulder. Inhale, release your gaze 45 degrees and your neck. Exhale. Inhale, chin to chest. Beautiful. Slowly make your way all the way onto your back. On an inhale, bring your knees up to your chest, squeezing them in, rocking from side to side. Thank you, body. Thank you, low back. Giving that low back a nice massage. You can do a couple circles, whatever feels good. Exhale, release them down, soles of the feet to the mat. Let those knees knock in towards one another. Breathe in constructive rest. You did it. On an inhale, bring your right leg up over your left knee, flexing that foot, and bring that left heel as close to your bum as you can and kind of let it relax a bit. You're in this figure four position. You can take your hands. This is a great stretch right here. So if that feels good, just kind of press into that.
Keeping both hips and both shoulders on the mat. Breathe. Or you can take both hands, pick up your left leg to a 90 degree angle and interlace your fingers behind that left leg and pull that left leg towards you as you exhale. Really feeling that deep stretch in the right hip. Breathe. Notice where your thoughts are. Notice where your body is. No judgment. You don't need to do anything or change anything or be anywhere. Inhale. Exhale, maybe pull a little bit deeper. Flexing those feet, breathing, releasing into the mat. Release what is not serving you. Beautiful. And inhale, bring that left foot down to the mat. Unwind the right foot. Bring that sole of the foot to the mat as well. And allow those knees to knock into each other for constructive rest. Notice where you are. On your next inhale, bring that left leg all the way up, flex your foot, and bring it across your right knee, or your right thigh, excuse me. Flex the foot, bring that right heel up to your bum, and then kind of relax it out. Just bring it a bit closer. You can press in here for a great stretch on that hip. Or you can interlace your fingers behind the right leg, bringing that right leg into a 90 degree angle, keeping your shoulder blades against the back of, you know, falling down your back against the mat. Excuse me. Pulling that leg towards your torso, finding length in your spine. You breathe. Inhale, finding length. Exhale, deepening the stretch. Breathe. Keep that foot flexed. Beautiful. Your next inhale, bring both soles of the feet to the mat and let your knees fall together for constructive rest. On your next inhale, bring your palms next to your hips. Bring your heels all the way up to your bum. Bring your palms next to your heels. Let your shoulder blades tuck one and the other underneath you. And we're going to be pressing into our hands and pushing our hips up toward the ceiling, all right? So on an inhale, we're going to press with our hands, pushing our hips up to the ceiling, finding length in the spine, pressing into all four corners of our feet. Exhale. Hold and inhale. Pressing up, pressing through the palms. One more breath. Exhale with control, slowly come down, vertebrae on top of vertebrae. Slowly down, beautiful, with control, gorgeous.
This time, when we bring our hands up, we're gonna also bring our, when we bring our hips up, we're gonna bring our hands above our head like this. Ready? On our next inhale, push those hips up and move your hands. Your hands go up and over, straight above you as you press into your feet. Gorgeous. Press into all four corners. Try and lengthen that spine, relax your shoulders. You should feel a lot of space in your neck. Press into those hips, press into those feet. Yes, exhale. Inhale, exhale, slowly bring your arms and your hips down, vertebrae on top of vertebrae. Hands coming all the way down to meet you. Beautiful. Inhale, just your hands all the way up and overhead. Exhale, relax them down. Inhale, hips come up, hands come down. Inhale and hold. Press into your feet. Exhale. Inhale, hands come up. Exhale, hold. On your next exhale, hands and hips coming down. Beautiful. Inhale, bring both knees to your chest. Massage your low back, rocking from side to side. Breathe. Inhale, bring your knees right out in front of you, making a 90-degree angle. On an inhale, push them out in front of you. Exhale, bring them in. Actually, we're gonna reverse that. So inhale, we're gonna bring them in. Exhale, push them out. Inhale, in, exhale, out. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Good, bring both feet to the floor. Reaching your, on a big inhale, reach your hands all the way up, reach your feet long in front of you for a good morning stretch. Beautiful. Coming all the way up to sit and bringing your right foot, your right leg in front of you. We're going to come into pigeon. We're going to bring this right knee to the upper right corner of the mat. The heel is towards your groin. Your left leg is long behind you. You're gonna breathe and find length in that spine, sitting back onto that right hip. Reaching forward with that heart, pressing into that right hip. Maybe you come forward onto your forearms. Maybe you come forward onto a block or a pillow. Maybe you stay in more of a seal. However your forward fold into pigeon is, take that now. And breathe. On your next inhale, come on up, pressing into your palms, switching your legs, pressing into your right heel, bringing your left foot forward, the knee, your left knee toward the upper left corner of the mat, your left heel towards your groin, and reaching back with that right foot long.
Find the length as you press into your left hip. Push into your hands, find length and shine your heart forward. Exhale. Inhale. Find length before you fold forward. Maybe coming to your forearms, coming all the way down to your forehead, or to a block. Wherever your fold is, listen to your body and breathe. On an inhale, press into your palms, bringing them underneath you. Exhale, as you shine that heart forward, pressing up, finding a little bit of length. Sinking into your hips. Inhale, press into your palms, come into that neutral tabletop. Bring your knees as wide as the mat. Toes together and come into an extended child's pose. Bring your head to touch the mat. Notice where you are. Quiet your mind. Kindly say, you can come back to that later. Return to your intention, your sankalpa, as you breathe. And release what is ever no longer serving you, no longer bringing you life. Breathe. Sink into those hips. Do a scan of your body and release any tension you may be feeling. Try and compassionately motivate your breath. You have everything you need inside you. You got this. On an inhale, press up, coming into our final poses. Take any pose that you need, maybe happy baby, anything that might be calling to you before Shavasana. Slowly come into all the way onto your back, bringing your legs out long, your hands out at your sides, open if you are looking to receive energy, or grounded on the floor if you're looking for grounding. Return to your sankalpa. Make any adjustments you need. Offer yourself gratitude. Begin to breathe. And allow this time to integrate
body. You are just where you need to be. Shavasana. Begin to bring movement back into your fingers and toes. Bring attention to your breath and to the world around you. Slowly roll to one side, pausing for a moment. Yourself up. Coming into your comfortable seat. Take a moment and breathe. Take one final breath together. Thank you so much for being here today. Offer gratitude for yourself, for you have shown up for yourself. You are here and you have made wonderful energy. And that is a beautiful thing. You've connected and been present. Thank you. On an inhale, we'll bring our hands to our heart center. And one final om. Would like to join me, you may. The light and the teacher in me honors the light, the teacher, the love. The love in me honors the love and light in you. Well, yogis. Thank you so much. I think it was longer than 30 minutes, but.